Welcome to PAR Podcast, episode 76.15. PAR Podcast is an audio supplement for Public Administration Review, the premier professional journal in the field of public administration. This year, 2015, PAR celebrates 75 years of furthering public administration research, theory, and practice. This episode features comments by Joshua Newman, a lecturer at Flinders University in Adelaide, South Australia, and an honorary research fellow in the Institute for Social Science Research at University of Queensland in Brisbane, Australia. Professor Newman discusses his article titled, Do Policymakers Use Academic Research? Re-examining the Two Communities Theory of Research Utilization, co-authored with Adrian Cherney and Brian W. Head. This article is currently available in Early View and we published in Public Administration Review, Issue 76, Volume 1.
This article finds its scholarly motivation in the research utilization discourse that happened in the 1970s and early 1980s, where scholars were highly interested in how research done by academics at universities can be used by government policymakers. More to the point, they were at the time very concerned that not enough research was being used and that academic research just wasn't seeing its full potential utilized. The discourse at the time resulted in what has come to be known as the two communities view of the relationship between research and policy. That is that academics on the one hand and policymakers on the other form two separate communities who are populated by separate citizens speaking different languages, responding to different incentives and rewards, and generally not interacting very much between them. This was adopted as sort of a consensus for many years and still has significant following at this time. More recently, since the early 2000s, a new discourse has appeared, one that centers around evidence-based policy. This discourse is still interested in how research is being used, but now the point is to find out how research can be used to improve policy, whereas before it was more interested in how research can be used for the sake of research. Nevertheless, the real question is, and has always been, why is research not used more by policymakers? And it really seems like policymakers aren't using academic research to its fullest potential. By taking a look at empirical studies that have been completed in the past in the US, in Canada, in the UK, in Australia and other countries, it would really seem like policymakers are not, on average, and even in majority, that interested in using academic research in making their policy decisions. What we noticed when we started this research project is that even in these empirical studies that show that academic research is not used by a majority of policymakers, each of these studies found that there was a core significant minority that did report that they did use research and that it had a substantial impact on their policy decisions and was a big influence and was valuable to them. This sort of indicates that a two communities perspective may not be entirely accurate, because the whole basis of the two communities metaphor is that these communities are essentially homogeneous. This is just empirically proven to not be true, because there are always this minority of respondents to surveys that say that research is important to them. So what our group at the University of Queensland did was they sent out a survey to over 2,000 public servants across the federal government and three states in Australia, and conducted in-person or telephone interviews, in-depth, semi-structured interviews with 126 senior public servants from a variety of areas and localities. And we asked them a variety of questions about how they use research and how important it is to them. Some of our results mirror results that have been obtained in previous studies in other countries. For instance, that the majority of our respondents said that they're not really that keen to use academic research, in part because they find it not related to the problems that they face, in part because the perceived timeline of academics is longer. Practitioners seem to think that they need emergency answers immediately, whereas academics will take far too long to answer specific questions. However, in our survey, and just like in other surveys, there were a significant number, albeit a minority, of respondents who replied that they did actually value academic research and they did use it in their policy decision making. More to the point, what we didn't find is a polarized response set in which all of the answers tended to show that policymakers weren't interested in research. We found a spectrum of use, with some public servants using research in their policy work more and others using it less, some being more in favor, others being less in favor, but generally a broad spectrum rather than concentrated at one end of the scale. Our interviews were similarly scattered. We had some responses that were fairly negative towards academic research and some that were quite positive. Negative responses tended to say things like academics don't work on quick enough time scale, or they write in a language that only other academics understand. And then the positive responses tended to say that they use research and value it greatly. An interesting thing that we found in our interview responses is that many of our respondents made statements about the political process and their role within it. One thing that these respondents seemed to agree on was that politicians set the policy agenda, and their job as bureaucrats is to implement the decisions that the politicians come up with. And in some cases, that means they're able to use research, but in many cases, it means that research that may disagree with the politician's preferences tends to get thrown out. So this is an interesting indication that seeing policymakers as one homogenous group has many other problems besides those that we initially thought of. There's an important distinction between administrative public sector decision makers and political public sector decision makers, and their use of research is going to be different. In general, the study's results, I think, tend to suggest that there is a substantial amount of hope for bridging the gap between academia and policy. There are policymakers who use research, who value it, and for whom research influences their policy decisions. And really the key here is to identify what their needs are and to identify the existing linkages between them and the academic sector and try to improve upon the linkages that already exist. In general, it's quite probable that a specialized industry might arise whereby so-called knowledge brokers or boundary spanners might find a whole career in making those links between academics and policymakers. But the point is that those links do seem to already exist, and really the path to move forward is to expand on those existing linkages. So in general, one of the central arguments of the two communities thesis is that the lines of communication between academia and policy seem to be broken. But this is demonstrably not true. There are, and in our Australian study and in other studies that came before it, there are linkages that already exist. And our survey results and our interview responses corroborate this.
This concludes PAR Podcast, episode 76.15. To listen to additional episodes and learn more about Public Administration Review, please visit us online at publicadministrationreview.org. You can also find us on Facebook and Twitter at PA Review. Thanks for listening.